Coach Andrews. Okay, OAC Divisional State.
Yep.
Barrel Monkeys today, right?
There's a lot going on. Yeah.
Okay, but you guys have a beautiful facility here.
Yeah, we're really fortunate, you know, we try to host as many events as we can.
When you look at, you know, bringing the OAC in, how much of a no-brainer was it for you guys?
Oh, I think, you know, obviously knowing Jared a really long time, as we looked and just as they continue to grow, we said we want to be involved in hosting whatever event you guys are willing to give us. And so 3 years ago, this is our third year, he came up with the idea of the Divisional State. So this is our third year doing it. It's a great organization. It's centrally located in Ohio. And for us, it helps us get as many of our own kids to take that next step to trying to compete in these levels.
Okay, so, you know, I walk in, and the first thing I see is a bunch of wrestlers. How did you manage to get all the wrestlers' pictures front and center? It's the first thing you see when you walk into Marysville High School.
I have nothing to do with that. That's all those kids, right? So in our school, if you are All-State, which is a state placer,
we got a guy right behind you.
Yeah, you get your pictures on the wall. And so it's just historically, wrestling has been, we've had the most level of All-State athletes compared to other sports. So they're everywhere.
Yeah, like I got the assassin over my shoulder right here. I got Romani. I got the H2P Pitt Panther.
Yes.
He's right over my shoulder. You know, you'll watch him.
Yes.
He'll pin you from anywhere.
Yes.
Okay. When you look at that, you know, you guys have put some guys onto the college level,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You got a lot of D1 guys, yeah. And then other divisions as well.
Yeah.
And I know that, you know, you wrestled in college. We were teammates.
Yeah.
When you look at the college level and getting them to that next level and understanding what the sport can do for you, how important is that for you as a coach?
Well, you know, I think to me, wrestling's all about creating opportunities for kids, right? So, like, the biggest thing when I think about it are we have kids who probably wouldn't have gone to college or wouldn't have gone to the caliber of college that they went to if it wasn't for wrestling. So just trying to instill that goal setting early on, you know, like trying to get them to wrestle at that level where they have those opportunities is really important. I mean, you know, we have two kids, one who's just graduated from Ivy League institution, another
Farr.
One Farr just graduated from Brown, he was here earlier today, and Jake Marks is at Princeton. So, you know, those are opportunities those kids wouldn't have had if it wasn't for wrestling.
All right, we got Graham here. It's Graham wrestling. Graham,
yes.
You wrestling?
Yeah.
All right, so Graham's got some pretty good genes.
Yeah,
mom's a gymnast at Kent State.
Athlete, yes.
I don't know if you know that, but Kyle Dake's mom was, I believe, a
yes.
gymnast at Kent State.
Yes.
Graham, you're right there, buddy. You're right there, all right?
Yeah.
So, you know, this is where you were born and raised, though.
Absolutely.
To be able to move back here, be the head coach. You took over for your dad, didn't you?
Yes.
What's that been like, and what's
you
that
know,
experience?
It's one of those things you never really plan. You know, when I left as a GA at Kent, my youngest two brothers were in high school, and I thought, well, I'll come back for a couple years and help them out. This is not going to be like a forever thing. It's been, you know, almost 20 years since then. You know, it's exciting. Like, I can look around. You talk about the pictures on the wall. You know, I can remember everybody back to Chad McGlone, who wrestled Greg Goad, who I just...
Are you serious?
Yeah. I watched all those guys wrestle in the state tournament. In fact, Chad was just talking to Greg recently. They, like, stay in touch.
On the
Oak Harbor connection. But, you know, it's just nice. You know, you know the legacy of it. You know all the kids, the guys who've gone through it. It's just trying to continue that. So... I wouldn't say it's more pressure, but it's you want to do it the right way.
And you guys are trending up in divisions. You're only going to grow as a school. The community's only going to grow. Well, Carver's shrinking, actually.
Yeah.
It's a real thing. I'm not making it up.
Yeah.
When you see that, those schools used to be, you know, they used to wrestle all the time. Ferd, my brother,
yeah.
Ferd wrestled. He had a guy state placer here, right? Grove, I think?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? So you look at it that way, the growth of the community.
Yeah.
What's that been like?
You know, for me, we've always been Division I since I've been coaching, right? So growing up, we were Division II. We went up to Division I for a couple of years, back down to Division II. And since, you know, really 2000, Ben Rings was the last guy who was a D2 state runner-up and then a D1 champ.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, and so then after that, we've been Division I since then. Because we're surrounded by farmlands. Columbus is growing outside of 270. So that's never going to change. And so for us, it's trying to get kids, hook them in early. I think we have 106 kids in our youth program. So just trying to get those guys to go beyond the rec level and participate in events like this today.
Okay, so talk youth. Obviously, if you don't have a good youth team, you're not going to have a good high school or junior high team. You know, obviously we got some, we're invested pretty heavily here.
Yeah.
When we look at, you know, Graham's right here, but you know, how important is the youth? How important is the development in these tournaments and it growing?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, that's if I look at the teams we've had that have been pretty good, it's kids and parents and families who are invested in wrestling beyond just that small window of a rec league season. So, you know, we're fortunate. We St. Paris Graham's 40 minutes away, so our guys can go wrestle with Coach Jordan. Moran's is 30 minutes away. Stever's 45 minutes away. So, you know, we really try to plant the seed here, do everything we can to develop them, but encourage them to wrestle in other places as well, because you know as well as I do, additional coaches and additional partners is what helps to raise the levels.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, in the area has grown up so much, like even since you were a kid, right?
Absolutely. When I graduated, there's a giant housing development across the road. It was a dairy farm. You know, I graduated with 100, 192 people in my graduating class, and I think this year we'll graduate about 450.
Who owns the house with the silo?
Ben, the one that's actually...
The one you grew up in, right? Oh, yeah. It has silo.
Helmuth Dairy Farm. They're sitting on a beach somewhere, for sure.
Wait a minute. But I'm saying, didn't you grow up in a house that had a silo? Didn't your dad make a silo?
No, that was Ben Rings.
That was Rings.
Rings.
Rings' house was a silo.
Yes, it took three silos, put them together, hollowed it out, and then turned it into, like,
living quarters.
Yeah.
Sorry, I confused that.
Yeah, no. Roughly the same time. I grew up with Ben's older brother, Matt. So.
Okay, so when you look at Marysville, what's the goals moving forward here? You've had state champs. You've had runner-up. You have finals. You have a guy who can win the ACC and be an All-American this year.
Yeah, I think, honestly, for us, it's continuing to stay in that top 10, and we're not there right now. So it's looking backwards and saying, getting our middle school kids competing in events like this and the OAC districts and trying to get the OAC states. It's taking the kids who are in youth and trying to, again, continue to move their levels because, my opinion is the top 5% in wrestling is growing exponentially, and everybody else is kind of living down here, and we got to try to stay with that 5%. And it's off season work. It's all the time. It's just a job. But it's fun. It's what I love.
You're going to run into something that's problematic for a lot of dads. How do you separate coaching and your emotions away from your kid developing and him getting better?
I would tell you, what I have said emphatically is I want to have a coaching staff that is strong enough that I can just let them coach him and I can just be a dad. Way easier said than done. If you ask him, I get frustrated in practices sometimes, but it's on effort, right? That's all I care about is effort. We just continue to build our coaching staff, continue to build the partners around them and give them opportunities so that I can not sit in the corner because I've just seen it go bad so many times.
Right? Yeah. And you're a pretty laid-back guy too, though. Okay, how's your wife doing?
She's awesome. She was just here. I just missed her.
You missed her?
Yeah.
Jeez, oh, peace. Where hopefully the athletic genes are going to come from here, right?
That's right.
Yeah. All right. You got anything else for me?
No, I just, listen, we appreciate, I think about how much wrestling's grown, right? And it's a direct result of guys like yourself. I mean, the fact that you can sit at home on a Friday night and watch Ohio State, Penn State, that you can just on a Sunday afternoon watch college wrestling, that you can get on and see results. And, today they're streaming this whole event on track wrestling. Like, guys like you who are on the forefront of doing that is what's allowed our sport to continue to grow, and we just appreciate what you're doing.
Thank you for the time. I'm glad you don't want to punch me in the face or anything. All right, that's good. Hey, thanks for the time. Good luck. Go Monarchs.
Thanks.